you start to think about, okay, how long is this going to go on for? Where is my rent coming from? You know, all of the normal things that everybody is worried about, we are too as tattoo artists.
You know, you hear the term like essential business all the time. Well, the way I look at it, if you are relying on your business to pay your rent, put food on your table, isn't every business essential?
It is tough. It is tough because I don't have money coming in. Actually, my husband and I are both small business owners, and there isn't the income coming in right now.
It's tough. It's really tough. The biggest thing is the people. Clients become friends. You miss having that connection with people and the interaction. So you kind of get depressed.
The thing I miss the most is interaction with different people every single day. One of the best parts about owning a tattoo shop has always been that you never have a day where you don't leave without a story about something that happened that was crazy to this person or that person, or even just the four of us. We're a really close team here.
I do miss the people interaction. I do miss my clients, and I do miss the process itself.
That was definitely the hardest part about all of this, is just going from being immersed in an environment where you're chatting with people and we're talking about politics and we're talking about music and fashion and art and all this stuff, to being taken out of that and at home by yourself, and really like the only communication that you have is through your mobile devices and stuff like that, which is great. Thank goodness we're in the tech era where we can actually do those things, but it's not the same as like real human contact.
Tattoos are very much like therapy. It sounds funny until you start to get them. And I got a lot of clients to say that they're soothing. I've had clients tell me things that they haven't told other people. I'm fortunate, you know, and I really appreciate that. And so it's, you open up because you spend a lot of time together with the artist.
Being in the shop is such a huge part of my life. I'm here more hours and I'm home. I think that the bonds that you create with your customers, it's very, very important, you know, especially when you're doing like large scale tattooing, because, you know, they're not coming in for 35 minutes and you see them every 4 years. You know, it's like I'm seeing these people at least once a month, you know, and you get to know about their life. You get to know about, you basically get to know everything about them. You're almost like a therapist, you know, and on the flip side of that, they get to know a lot about you too, because like the conversations just flow back and forth.
As you're tattooing day to day, week to week, realize how many people are in and out of your life over the course of that time. And then when it all shut down, I started, you know, getting a couple hundred people at a time showing up on our Instagrams, and they're all like, I miss the place, and I miss you guys, and I can't wait to get another tattoo. And I realized that it doesn't really always have to do with just getting the tattoo, but it's like people have these places that they like to go in their lives, whether it's Starbucks or, you know, your friend's house or something like that. And now all of that's been removed. During the time we've been closed, myself and a lot of the other artists have been concentrating on our illustration. This is a book that I've been working on for a number of years of my designs.
Friend of mine, she was making the masks, and I'm like, oh my God, I can do it. It can keep me busy. They offer it, it's a donation to whoever need them. So like, it doesn't matter if you nurse or you just need it for your family. Like, I just ask people to send me your address, your name, and amount of masks that you absolutely need. You know, especially if you're out of job, you know, I'd rather them spend this money on food than, you know, something that I can provide.
We as tattooers, not just at this shop, but as an industry, we're professionals. You know, this is our life. And we have always maintained standards to keep everybody safe and healthy. And we're going to continue to do that. We have never and would never put anyone's health or safety at risk. And I think just going forward, all tattoo shops, all tattoo artists, we're willing to do whatever it takes to survive.
Because I work with men and women usually that are of a compromised after cancer, breast cancer, I opted to close earlier because of the risks that were involved. So I know that when we do get the okay from the town and the state, that we will be able to give everybody this safe environment to have their tattooing done.
I want everybody to be comfortable. That's why everything is opened in front of you. everything is disposed in front of you. You know, it's all putting it, the customer at ease.
We're trying to put together a nice checklist of all the things we'll be expected to do and the things we want to do for our clients in going forward in the future when we're ready to open.
We are going to implement some new procedures going back into working after quarantine. When you come into the shop, you're going to have to wear a mask. We will provide hand wipes so that people can clean their hands the second they come through the door. We're also going to require people to clean their cell phones. We usually would allow one friend back into the actual tattoo area, but that's going to have to change. We've also purchased handheld UV sterilizers. The one thing that we are hearing is that UV light is bad for this virus. It doesn't like it. So once we set up, we're gonna take our UV wand lights, which are handheld. We're gonna just go over the area, re-sterilize that. And we've also bought an antimicrobial filter for our air system. Anything that's in the air, anything that's, you know, airborne is going to be filtered throughout the shop.
It is hard. It's hard for everybody. Hopefully that we will get to a place where we can come back into business and do what we need to do. I love what I do. I miss it.
We don't want COVID-19 to destroy our industry, and we're not going to let that happen.
We'll get through this and I'll be open.